Hi everyone. First of all, I would like to emphasize two situations that may require recommendations in LeapSet. The first scenario is, let's say John lives in Washington, and now he is looking for a restaurant in California which matches very well with his tastes and preferences. So we have to help him. The second scenario is, let's say Tom is a LeapSet merchant who is eager in upselling and cross-selling. But how does he know which item he should recommend for which user? So we have to help him as well. So this is the basic idea of collaborative-based filtering. So what is happening in collaborative filtering is, first, we identify a cluster of users who have similar kind of attitudes, and then by analyzing the big data related to that cluster and comes up with various suggestions which are helpful for a user. So in LeapSet, we have the concept of big data with us as a very hot topic. Therefore, I think this feature would be a very appropriate one to implement. Thank you.
You read a small
data. Yeah, so basically you're saying looking at the data analytics, do kind of trends and stuff and recommendations for users, right?
You bring the element of similar consumers into the picture. If you are a donut lover, you figure out other donut lovers and other donut lovers in other states. Where do they you can get information from a store. This is a store that they sell a lot of donuts.
These are all LeapSet merchants.
All LeapSet consumers. So this is a recommendation system that gets evolved between the LeapSet consumers and merchants. You learn it from the others' pattern.
So currently, how are you planning to get the data, and what data do we have, and how are you going to do the recommendations?
For a usual recommendation system, there are two ways that we can get the data. The first way is implicit way. Yeah, the other way is explicit way. Explicit way is what is happening in a rating system. But in implicit way, we can use all the historical data of how already we have that. Data, historical data of all users that we have, but we don't have a profile like system. We have to create that. After creating such profile in the data warehouse, we can very easily implement this product.
So what are the parameters that will take into account for determining the recognition?
Yes, that's a very important question, because every recommendation system should have a mathematical model, but this is the first time that we are going to implement a recommendation system in a food industry. Therefore, the mathematical model would be different from other kinds of recommendation systems, but this is good.
Where is the representation? This is for the consumer or the merchant?
Yeah, both.
Yes.
Now, in the previous scenario, that I said,
I understood your both scenarios. How are you going to, where is the physical representation? This is a website.
Yeah, no, it's on our US application, Android application, as well as the other application. Yeah.
No, one question. There is individual now who's coming from out of state.
Yeah.
Into the state where we have LeapSet now. Your system is good, right? Your presentation is good. But now, how do you plan to get this individual who knows nothing about LeapSet, who's not using anything that LeapSet provides, into this system, into using this? How do you recommend it? Because your individual is coming from another state, knows nothing about LeapSet, is not using anything that LeapSet has provided. That'll be a real time scenario. So how do you expect, how do you plan to get him to use this system?
This is not for new people.
This is
one thing. So that's a prerequisite. It has to be within the LeapSet
So you just have done some transactions with it. Basically, what he's saying is you do some transactions and you create a profile of that user. That's a leap set consumer profile, and then you analyze the profile saying he likes to eat Chinese, he likes to eat Indian or Wednesdays like that, and then when he goes,
the thing is, in all recommendation systems, we have that cold start problem. Because for a newcomer, this, in every recommendation system, it's hard to make recommendations for newcomers. But after that, when you are getting data as much as possible,
no argument about that. But this is also look at the opportunity also, right, from the other hand. If we have a good recommendation system, that is a mechanism to get people attracted into the system. Coming. So look at the opportunity.
And for the merchant,
like this one, no? And how do you and think of how you are going to attract somebody who is outside of the deep set to be using it?
In that way, you can use that the recommendation system for merchant as well. Because he can use it for upselling and cross-selling scenarios. In that case, you don't need such data. But he can use it.
Can you elaborate a little bit on an upselling scenario? Can you explain a little bit the scenario where there is a customer who is a frequent lead set user at the restaurant? How will the merchant use this system to?
Yes, because.
What is the information that you have to recommend something to that customer? How is it?
Yes, all the it is based on all the demographic data of the user, including gender, the locations that he is visiting, what kind of dishes he prefer, and such kind of things. And I think currently, merchant can't recommend that make such kind of recommendation for user. That's a problem. Even we are having all the historical data of every transaction that we made. So I think we need such a system.
Have you thought about how you're going to show that information to the merchant?
Yes.
Do I have to check in as a customer? I have to check in first? How will you know that?
So the merchant's involvement here is very limited, I think. This recommendation is coming.
I am the customer, but on the merchant side, how does the merchant know that
I am
in the list?
Basically, the question is, okay, how it would happen now when you develop this system?
Yes.
What would happen? How it would happen to this system? What will happen like a customer comes in and what's the flow? How will flow? Like,
yes.
That's the question.
Yeah.
So you recognize from a check-in when you come to it.
Yeah,
you check-in.
Right.
Check-in triggers that this particular consumer has walked in. Probably a pop-up saying he's a, for instance, Rasika, basically lover, likes good service, good tipper, things like that. You cross an upsell based on that. Oh, and tell us.
All the proceedings and all kind of things we are doing in offline, and we can store that the separate, relational databases. So in real time, we can supply recommendations for them without the event.
So one challenge here would be to come up with a good recommendation.
Yes,
first you have to create a solid profile with key attributes, and then through that you have to build an algorithm and then
everything. Yes, because previous kind of algorithm that I referred to in the papers of this scenario, and now when you are looking at the previous kind of algorithms that they have used, now today even in the R language is what we are using in manipulating regression kind of statistical calculations in data warehouse. So therefore, today all the calculations related to recommendation systems, they are doing using statistical regression. So it's a new news for us. We can do that without any matter.
Okay.
further questions? Yes, sir.
So, this is primarily targeting in store and online, or just in store? For walking customers or?
Yeah, walking customers.
So, there's nothing online recommendations?
There can be online as well. Like you're trying to order something,
yeah.
Like in Amazon.
Yeah. Okay. And so the next one is basically, so do you see this being used more in a QSR type model or more in a restaurant sit down type model where you would actually make recommendations?
Both.
And so in like a sit down type mode, you would really need the recommendation done at the table, so that would need to be on an order pad or something like that.
Because the previous scenario we had told about the cross-selling and upselling scenario, that's going to be happening in
the mobile apps.
Yeah, well as.
No, I mean like at a QSR type model, will you actually do a lot of recommendations? Do you have time to do or the user already knows what he wants? Does he come there and he basically looks at it and thinks, oh, what do I want? Or does he already know what he wants? So will you actually be doing any cross-selling at that time? What I'm asking, it's more suitable, it seems like it's more suitable for a sit down where the waiter walks up to you and he says, you know what, you already checked this.
It's up to the customer to make the recommendations if he needs.
No, you're not giving physical recommendations. Merchant is not going and say, I'm going to recommend this to this guy. So basically, this guy has a profile,
right?
Fanta and Chinese, and let's say he likes fried rice, right? He comes into the restaurant, he orders something else.
Right.
But the algorithm may figure out, hey, by the way, this guy has a pattern of liking Fanta Chinese.
Right.
But
they don't do any physical, I mean, they don't do any
recommendations. The algorithm will promote that, saying, hey, by the way, this merchant has these things, these are things you like it.
But I mean,
Shine,
so basically.
Is that right? It depends on checking in.
Yeah, you're.
So there is a little bit of time there. So,
right.
So as it checks in.
No, so that's why I said, on a QSR type mode, why would they actually check in, right?
Yeah, that is a different. I think this is based on the assumption that you do check in.
Right. Yeah.
And after you check in, let's say you like burgers, fries, and onion rings all the time. You order burgers and fries, then the operator can say, you know, it's onion rings.
Yeah, and the other thing is you don't have to check in. So you have that location based thing. But you're based on where you're within the. No, you build something, right? Which is like if you are in the region of the place recently, auto check-in or something, which is not present in the restaurant, outside the restaurant. So if you're walking outside the restaurant, the POS knows that this guy is outside and this is his profile, automatically you send a message saying, hey, there's a whiskey promotion going on right now in this restaurant.
Alright,
sure. Anything else?
The only thing here is that the needs of ecosystem is not large enough yet to be very effective here. We have only 500 merchants, right? We have a lot of data, but you know, to recommend restaurants and stuff, it's very small. Maybe we can recommend dishes and stuff.
Alright, if there are no further questions, then let's call our next.